Hello there. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Reading Tarot in 1 Hour. I'm Zelda Kelly. I'm here and I'm excited to guide you through this basics of tarot reading. And I want to be able to give you enough to where tonight or tomorrow you can sit down with your deck of cards and you can begin the reading process. Now, all of this takes practice. You're not going to know everything in one sitting. And that's why I invite you to either keep notes, do your own study, or just keep practicing. Practice on family and friends. Practice on people that will help you understand your intuition and what you're getting. Now, one thing I am going to tell you, you do not have to be psychic to read the tarot cards. I know many people who are not and who are excellent readers. So just keep that in mind. Don't hold yourself back. The cards will definitely help you. By the end of this session, and by the end of this video series, you will have a solid foundation of where to start the reading with the tarot cards on your own. For this introduction, I'm going to cover some essential aspects of the tarot and recommend starting with the Rider-Waite tarot deck. And there's a reason. You can either use the Rider-Waite or the Universal Rider-Waite. These decks are ideal for beginners and because they are easy to decode and decipher. And for those of you who are seasoned readers, I invite you to just follow along, and I'm so glad you're here, and thank you so much for your support in this. Now, this is why I'm saying to get a Rider-Waite deck. You see, this is the Temperance card, and we're going to go over this in a minute. She's part of the Major Arcana. There are 22 cards in the Major Arcana, and 56 cards in the Minor Arcana. Now, some people say Arcana, Arcaner. That is a preference that you are welcome to have. But this is the reason why. This is a beautiful deck. This is the Oak, Ash, and Thorn Tarot deck. I love this tarot deck, and I use it often. If you watch my videos, you're going to see this deck. But look at this Temperance card. You see what I mean? This is the Harmony Tarot deck. It's closer to her. But you're missing some elements there. And then check this out. This is the Lisa Parker Tarot deck. It's just gorgeous. But look at this. So that's why I want to teach you on this particular deck first. And then you're welcome to use whatever deck once you get the tarot meanings and the card attributes down pat. Now, the tarot is definitely a tool for gaining insight and clarity. And each card has a designated color and musical note. We'll get into that some other time. And if you're really interested in that, I have a series, and I'll link it here. You can go see it. It's called The Great 78 that I'm working on. And I go through card by card. Musical note, color, the attributes of the card, and reverse. Reverse meanings. Now, before I get started, reverse meanings are very important to some, and they are to me as well. But I don't read in reverse meanings. Some people say, well, you're cheating people out of 78 other meanings and so forth. Maybe. But you know, when you have a devil card and a tower card and negative cards come up, that's pretty negative. And with my guides assisting me, if there is a negative card that comes up, I'm going to be able to tell by the surrounding cards how either someone can handle this, or should handle it, or should prepare to handle it, and if it's temporary or long term. That is the most important thing, and I'm going to say this is a preference. So just remember, when I say reverse, it would be looking like this. So there's nothing wrong with that. Like I said, it's a matter of preference. But I read upright. And especially when I'm reading for someone in front of me, I don't like to confuse people. But if you do read reverse meanings, nothing wrong with that, then the card would then take on the opposite meaning. So if you have a positive card, and this is pretty positive, and so is this one, but if it comes up reverse, that isn't such a positive card, and neither isn't this one. So you're going to have to depend on the meanings and the attributes of each card, whether reverse or upright. It's a preference. It's up to you. So I want you to understand in detail how things are going to be coming about for you and how you feel about your cards. If you're dealing with a brand new deck, I suggest holding your deck, just sitting and holding it. Just you can shuffle. Now, I've had these cards for a long time. You may be able to tell that. You can see they're pretty worn on the edges. I have another deck that is very old, and look at this. This came out. But just so you know, you have to explore this on your own. I can give you the foundation and the basics, but now this is going to be up to you. And how good of a reader you're going to be. That's the most important part. And that takes practice. I've been reading for decades, and every day I learn something new. But just so you know, there is a suit for every card. We have the pentacles. Some people call them coins. There's a wand. Then there's a major arcana. And then there's another major arcana. We have cups. And the last one is a sword. Now, each one of them have a different attribute in itself. And each one of them can have a different season. And we'll go through that with each one of the suits. But in order to prepare, I want you to find a very quiet place. Do not be distracted. Turn your phone off. Shut your windows if you have to. Go to a quiet room. Turn off your phone. Turn off your TV, all of your electronics, and close the door. Because you're about to embark on something that you can use for a lifetime. And that is very, very true. You need to set your intention to start reading, and then you must shuffle your cards. Now, when you get your brand new deck, you're going to see that each suit is together, 1 through 10, and then the major arcana, minor arcana are together. You're going to have to really shuffle them good, and the best way that I do it is when I get a new deck, is I just shuffle. I go through like this. Take a few and start dividing them out, because that's the really best way so you don't get a reading full of wands or full of cups and nothing else. That's not going to give you a good reading. So I wanted to give you all of these things as an introduction, because this is going to help you definitely. The power of the cards are very important. So shuffling these cards. And the first thing that you can do, see, now look, you see what happened? When you shuffle the cards, it's different that one card pops out or two. This hit my thumb. So you're going to have to recognize when spirit has a message to give you, or when your thumb gets in the way, or a finger gets in the way. But you just shuffle, and you keep shuffling until you decide or you feel that you don't have to shuffle anymore. Now, the one thing is, I don't let anyone handle my cards. If I have another reader come to visit, I don't say, here you go, read my cards. And that other reader would never ask me, because it's respect. And I would never read anyone else's cards, unless a card deck was gifted to me. You don't do that. In fact, when someone is sitting in front of me, I don't even ask them to touch or to cut the cards for me. What I do ask them is just while I'm shuffling, they can say, okay, stop, or okay, that's fine, or whatever the case may be. Now, that card was kind of flipping around, and I turned that around, and this is actually a good card that indicates something is going to come through quickly. So you can do one card readings, you can do 12 card readings, you can lay all 78 out if you want to, and read it as a story. That's the most important part. So for now, grab your deck, let's go through this, and thank you so much because I am so glad you are here. Stay tuned. Let's get started.